So now that we've got the OHL AGM meetings in the books, GMs, they got together, and we have a few trades to discuss. We did hear some rumors that a move was on the way involving the Flint Firebirds, and that trade has happened this morning. It's a three-way deal that involves the Flint Firebirds, Niagara Ice Dogs, and the Barrie Colts. So how it all works is that the Niagara Ice Dogs kind of play the middleman in this deal, and it sees Tristan Bertucci end up in Barrie. So Bertucci coming to the Barrie Colts for next season. He's a Vaughan native, so he gets to play closer to home. And he's kind of the big name in this deal. Of course, he's a Dallas Stars prospect. And I think Barrie Colt fans are going to be quite excited to see what Bertucci can do, potentially in a pairing with Bo Akey as early as this upcoming season. Also on the move, Artem Frolov and Urban Podrakar, they're on their way to the Flint Firebirds, along with the rights to Hayden Reid and five draft picks. And that includes Oshawa's second round pick in 2025. So the Flint Firebirds getting a decent haul for Tristan Bertucci, who kind of goes through Niagara to end up with the Barrie Colts. Now for the Ice Dogs, through all of this, they end up with Jack Browdy, Blair Scott, and six draft picks. And that includes Barrie's second round pick in 2026. So it's kind of tough seeing Frolov and Podrakar end up with the Flint Firebirds, but having Browdy and Scott, not too bad for this Niagara Ice Dogs team. So for Bertucci, like I said, he's a Dallas Stars prospect. And last season, despite even being a defenseman, ended up fifth in scoring for the Flint Firebirds. 10 goals, 34 assists, good for 44 points. It's going to be interesting to see what Marty Williamson does with the defense with the Barrie Colts, as it's looking pretty solid going into next year. You could put Bo Akey and Tristan Bertucci together in your top pairing, and then that leaves Kayshawn Aitchison and maybe even Grayson Tiller as your second pair. So things looking pretty solid on the blue line for this Barrie Colts team going into next season. And it's kind of a response to seeing the Brampton Steelheads make their moves. Of course, they acquired Carson Rakoff. They're looking to be the top team in the Central Division, but the Barrie Colts wanting to have a solid run as well. So we could see Brampton and Barrie being the 1 and 2 teams in that Central Division when things are all said and done. But I do think that Jack Browdy, a bit of a loss, because he had a decent year in his first season with the Barrie Colts. And I'm curious as to see with the extra ice time what he's capable of doing with the Niagara Ice Dogs. Because last year, Browdy had 21 points in 62 games, showed a lot of potential, and I think he's going to fit in well with the Niagara Ice Dogs, the ice time that he's going to get there. As for Blair Scott, he was acquired at the OHL trade deadline last year from Kitchener in the Edwards Chalet deal. Scott, late in the season, started to show more of his shot from the point. And I think as he gets more comfortable, he gets that extra confidence and ice time with the Niagara Ice Dogs. We'll see if Scott's shot will come out a little bit more, maybe get some power play time with the Ice Dogs, which would go a long way for him. Considering the defensive unit with the Barrie Colts, Scott probably wouldn't have seen a lot of ice if he stuck around with the Barrie Colts. So I think this move is good for him, getting that chance to put his skill set on display with the Niagara Ice Dogs. Now, Urban Podrakar and Artem Frolov, I think that's going to hurt Niagara a bit. Frolov, he's going to have a breakout season, I believe. He kind of was not on the score sheet all that often, but he's got that defensive ability, which is going to go a long way for the Flint Firebirds. Last season, he only had a goal and 11 assists in his rookie season for the Niagara Ice Dogs. So I expect those offensive numbers to go up, especially with the Flint Firebirds, who are going to be competitive next year. Podrakar, though, he's an import defenseman, 3 goals, 19 assists, 22 points in his first season in North America. So he's a bit of a smaller defenseman at 5'11", but a pretty good skater. So we'll see how that transpires with the Flint Firebirds. And of course, at Niagara, this is a franchise trying to turn things around. The last time they were in the OHL playoffs was in 2019. So getting Browdy and Scott, we'll see if that can increase their chances as they get a little bit younger. But then Frolov and Podrakar make their way to the Firebirds. So obviously the Barrie Colts, they get the biggest name in this trade with Tristan Bertucci, keeping pace with Brampton. But Niagara, I think this might be a bit of a step back, although I really like Jack Browdy's play. So it's really too bad to see him move on from the Barrie Colts. But if you're going to make a trade for Tristan Bertucci, you have to trade assets. And that's what happened here in this deal. But as for the Flint Firebirds, yeah, losing Bertucci is going to hurt because he was, like I said, top five in scoring last season for Flint. But this team's already made several moves during the offseason to really put themselves in a spot where maybe they can take top spot in the West Division. The West is wide open. We're waiting to see what are the Saginaw Spirit going to do. They did a lot of movement. They went all in last year as Memorial Cup hosts. So you kind of expect them to sell off. The Sioux Greyhounds have a lot of graduating players, while Windsor and Sarnia in the rebuild process. So I think Flint looking to fill that void in the West. I'm going to do a whole preview on the West Division in the coming days, but I think despite losing Bertucci, the Flint Firebirds are still in a pretty good spot going into 24-25. Now, there were a couple other trades announced this morning. The Brampton Steelheads continue to add. This time, they're picking up Spencer Sova from the Erie Otters. Sova entering his overage season after posting a 31-point year with the Erie Otters. He had 14 goals, 17 assists. He also was the captain of the Erie Otters last season. So he brings that leadership skill set to the Brampton Steelheads, as this is a group in Brampton that's looking for a very deep playoff run. Going the other way, the Otters, they receive a 15th round pick in 2028 and three conditional picks. That includes a second round pick in 2025 and also the rights to Coben Bryant, who is an 18-year-old defenseman from Clearwater, Florida. He was selected 196th overall in the 2022 priority selection by the Steelhead. So this trade is something that it makes sense for the Brampton Steelheads because they only have one overager listed on the roster, and that was Stevie Leskovar. So Sova will fit right in with this team after they also picked up Carson Rakoff. So it makes sense for the Steelheads to add a player like Sova. As for the Otters, it's a tough loss losing your captain, but at least they're getting assets in return for an overage player because they do have decisions to make. After Sova, they still have Caleb Smith, Sam Alfano, Bruce McDonald, and Pano Femis, all overage candidates. So that's four forwards, and they need to trim that down to three at some point during the regular season. You can carry four overagers during the start of the season, but you can only dress three. So some decisions still need to be made for this Erie Otters team. Getting some assets, like I said, for Sova is a good sign for the Erie Otters, but still not easy to lose a player like that. But the Erie Otters, they weren't done today. There was one other trade announced this morning as they've acquired Gabriel Frasca from the Kingston Frontenacs. So a busy day for the Erie Otters today as they gear up for training camp that gets underway this weekend. So they also get Owen Sound's 10th round pick in 2028 for six draft picks. So that includes 2 seconds in 2027 and 2028. So Frasca missed a lot of time last year due to injury, appeared in 44 games, but still put up 15 goals, 17 assists, 32 points. So Frasca does have a nose for the net. He's a very offensively gifted forward. But the Erie Otters, they want a challenge in the Midwest Division next season. And with Frasca, if he can stay healthy, I think this trade will work out for the Erie Otters for next year. They did give up more picks than I thought they would have for a player like Gabriel Frasca, but for the Kingston Frontenacs, this is going to benefit them. They've already made several moves this offseason. I just did the season preview video for the East Division talking about the Kingston Frontenacs, how I kind of view them as the dark horse in the East Division. They could challenge for top spot, but moving on from Gabriel Frasca, obviously the Frontenacs maybe not seeing something there, or maybe Frasca would like a change of scenery. Not 100% sure why they would move on with Frasca. I've heard rumors, but nothing to confirm it. Still, these are draft picks that the Frontenacs can now use to maybe acquire some more depth going into next season. So time will tell. The Kingston Frontenacs are in a pretty decent spot. And this is kind of what we see ahead of training camp. You see these moves of overage players so they can have a place to play next season. And also players that are looking for a change of scenery will get that as well. Still, we got another week to go before training camp gets underway. The first preseason games will begin on August 30th, so the countdown is on. But still, we got some big moves today, and we'll see what else transpires between now and the start of training camp. So let me know in the comments section down below your thoughts on today's trades, and what do you expect from your team going forward as we prepare for the upcoming OHL season. Thanks again for all your support. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe. We'll talk to you again soon.